Our children are being groomed.
Groomer controversy.
And shaming the groomers.
The term groomer.
There's a new conspiracy theory raging across the right.
The real conversion therapy that happens in our world today is the kind where a child is converted into LGBT.
They peddle a completely false conspiracy theory that LGBTQ people are quote unquote grooming children.
They're just evil. They're bad people. And they want to groom kids.
In April 2022, a Washington Post investigation revealed the identity of the creator of Libs of TikTok, a Twitter account whose popularity has exploded across the political right.
Libs of TikTok set the agenda for much of the right wing and media on all things cultural, especially about LGBT issues in education.
I really think Libs of TikTok is one of the most important journalists in America.
It turns out the account is run by a former Brooklyn real estate agent named Chaya Raichik, who's become the darling of right-wing media and politicians.
There's a lot of videos with LGBT activists indoctrinating kids.
But Libs of TikTok is only one of a new wave of right-wing influencers who have built their fame on one specific strategy, whipping up anxieties over a so-called LGBTQ agenda.
What were once fringe views about the LGBTQ plus community have become increasingly normalized by conservative politicians and pundits.
This is how the groomer conspiracy theory is reshaping right-wing politics and how this can lead directly to violence and murder.
Queer lives are under attack. What do we do? Stand up, stand up.
Three ways that you can make your classroom a little bit more inclusive to LGBTQIA+ students this coming up school year.
Libs of TikTok mainly reposts content from ordinary social media accounts and frames it to generate outrage, specifically suggesting that a huge, threatening cultural movement is coming for your kids.
A really key message in content that's posted from Libs of TikTok is the idea that LGBTQ people and teachers are sort of leading children down a certain ideological path.
It's a simple strategy, but one that's very effective at playing on people's fears around gender identity and driving hate clicks from the right. Raychick started out as an obscure poster of QAnon-style conspiracy content until she struck upon her successful Libs of TikTok formula. This led to her winning shout-outs from influential figures like Joe Rogan.
There's a thing called Libs of TikTok.
And saw her profile soar as a result.
Initially, her defense has been, oh, I just repost content. I'm not doing anything original here. But as she's sort of revealed her face and gone on this tour of far-right media, she's said that LGBTQ folks are mentally ill. You know, the mask has really come off.
Well, Matt Walsh won the Transphobe of the Year award. And I was super envious because I really wanted to win it.
And the issue that Libs of TikTok has primarily built its popularity on is the new wave of anti-LGBTQ groomer conspiracies.
Involving children in drag events in any capacity should be outright criminalized everywhere. There is no other way. You know, this doesn't stop until police are breaking down the doors at these places and carting the adults away in handcuffs. Charge them all as pedophiles.
Grooming refers to an idea that adults who are interacting with young children are somehow coercing them into a sexually abusive relationship. And that is sort of the legitimate context in which grooming is applied. And we know that that's an actual issue facing young children right now that, you know, is separate from the ways in which the grooming narrative has been applied to the LGBTQ plus community.
This right-wing online clout chasing has real-world consequences.
Threat of a device at Children's Hospital.
In August 2022, Raychick falsely accused the Boston Children's Hospital of performing hysterectomies on children as part of gender-affirming care.
Since August, investigators say threats of violence have come in through email, online messages, and phone calls, prompted by the hospital's transgender health program.
We know that there is this direct correlation between being mentioned on this account and the targets of those tweets experiencing harassment, threats, and even acts of violence.
While the hospital does offer some gender-affirming care, like chest reconstruction for patients 15 and over with parental permission, it explicitly does not offer hysterectomies to under 18-year-olds. Obviously, anti-LGBTQ violence and hate speech from the right is nothing new, but something different is happening here.
Stop grooming kids, you sick pedophile.
The backlash is rooted in anxieties over growing trans visibility and changing ideas around gender. This has spiraled into a blowback against the LGBTQ community as a whole, spawning unfounded conspiracies of a global queer agenda, specifically aimed at corrupting, sexualizing, or grooming children. This online conspiracy mongering can lead to people actually being murdered.
Police say at least five people are dead after a shooting at a Colorado Springs nightclub.
In November 2022, a 22-year-old named Anderson Lee Aldrich walked into a well-known queer club in Colorado wearing body armor and carrying an AR-15-style assault rifle. The shooter killed five people before being disarmed by an Army veteran who was in the crowd.
Everybody in that building experienced combat that night, not to their own accord, but because they were forced to.
As soon as news of the shooting broke, a familiar cast of toxic, far-right, and perpetually online network of politicians and social media personalities, including Libs of TikTok, kicked into action.
We need the police to shut these events down, but it's not going to happen. And I fear what will start to happen is more violence.
The common theme in their commentary was that the shooting was somehow justified, or at least understandable, because the club had held a drag brunch to commemorate victims of anti-trans violence. In fact, the shooting in Colorado was only the latest in a series of incidents of armed intimidation and anti-LGBTQ violence, including plots to attack pride parades and firebombing venues that held queer-friendly events.
Hundreds of thousands of dollars in damages after police say a man brazenly set fire to it Sunday just before 9:30 p.m.
Militant groups like the Proud Boys has started turning up to queer events across the country with automatic weapons.
It's one of a number of drag story hours disrupted by far-right protesters this year, including in Nevada, Oregon, and California.
Across the U.S., acts of political violence against the LGBTQ community have tripled from 2021 to 2022.
Far-right groups tend to be opportunistic. Proud Boys are one of the groups that engages most frequently in drag show protests. Proud Boys were intimately engaged in protests against mask mandates or vaccine requirements. This then shifted over time towards the anti-LGBTQ plus rhetoric.
Members of the Proud Boys stood watch at the meeting of the New Hanover County Board of Education.
A group of men believed to be affiliated with the far-right extremist Proud Boys group stormed the event. They made white power hand gestures as they began hurling homophobic and transphobic insults at Dulce.
After decades of LGBTQ gains in terms of winning marriage rights and increased representation in society, the sudden wave of animosity shows that something's changed. Gender is suddenly the hot new battleground for far-right influences.
There's this confusion about what is this talk about gender? Why are we suddenly concerned about pronouns? Why are we suddenly having these conversations about bathrooms? And then that fear of something unknown can very easily be cultivated into something much more hateful.
Hey kids, my name is Pastor David, and I wanted to tell you today that there is no such thing as drag, there is no such thing as transgender.
We go from a very grounded debate about what gender actually means to a conversation that includes accusations and like painting these people as monsters rather than engaging with them as the humans that they are.
In fact, research suggests that transphobia, specifically, can often act as a kind of gateway prejudice, and that this is worsened by social media. This wave of hatred isn't just driven by cynical Twitter users or far-righters in Fred Perry shirts. This conspiracist hysteria has spread from the extremist fringes to the very heart of the Republican Party.
We are not going to be injecting things like gender ideology into our elementary schools.
In 2021, legislators introduced 131 anti-trans bills across 34 states, covering everything from school curricula to who can use which bathrooms.
Critics call it the Don't Say Gay bill. Now, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis has signed it into law.
Perhaps the most infamous and divisive example of this is the so-called Don't Say Gay law.
Millions of parents are grateful for that. So is Christina Pushaw, who's the press secretary for the governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis. It was partly in response to videos that she saw on Libs of TikTok that Florida ultimately banned public school teachers from lecturing kindergartners about sex.
The law essentially sought to ban any discussion of LGBTQ issues in schools, but it faced opposition from an unlikely source, Disney.
Hundreds of people, parents and even kids, demonstrating in front of Walt Disney Studios in Burbank, saying the company is leaning too far left.
Disney is Florida's largest private employer and spoke out openly against the law. This resulted in a wave of protests and intimidation from right-wing groups at Disney's offices and theme parks.
For Disney to come out and put a statement and say that the bill should have never passed and that they are going to actively work to repeal it, I think one was fundamentally dishonest, but two, I think that crossed the line.
DeSantis, along with Florida's Republican establishment, came out on the side of the militias, threatening legal retaliation against the company.
Today, Florida's Republican-controlled House gave final legislative approval to a measure revoking a special tax district that has allowed Disney to self-govern its land.
Being prepared to alienate a major Florida employer shows just how crucial attacking LGBTQ people has become to the current conservative movement.
So there are these online amplifying accounts that start pushing ideas around grooming. Those then get picked up by right-wing media and promoted because it drives clicks. And we know that a lot of these right-wing media outlets are intimately connected with politicians. And so then we start seeing those same talking points getting picked up in congressional campaigns.
The idea that certain groups are out to harm children is an insidious framing that we see in many conspiracy theories and moral panics.
Our leaders are literally using the blood of children to fuel everything.
It's an obviously emotive issue, which is easy to use to drive hatred and hysteria.
This is a particular game of semantics around the idea of grooming. Anybody that tries to push back against these conspiracy theories are met with a reaction in which they themselves are being called groomers or supportive of the sexual abuse of children.
So instead of creating like meaningful systemic change that protects children and reduces sexual assault and sexual abuse, instead we start hunting down some sort of boogeyman.
Personal beliefs aside, it's clear that storming kids' events with assault weapons, bullying people online, and shutting down children's hospitals isn't helping anyone. And clearly, demonizing LGBTQ people as groomers is hateful and downright dangerous.
I will sign a new executive order instructing every federal agency to cease all programs that promote the concept of sex and gender transition at any age.
But one thing does look likely. As the US gears up for its elections in 2024, the culture wars over trans rights, gender, and LGBTQ people just wanting to live freely and visibly in society will continue to rage.